Now that we have our Linux Mint Mate computer all up to date, we want to personalize it a little bit by changing the background. To do this, I'm going to right-click on the desktop and select Change Desktop Background. This may take some time. You might have to be a little patient. There it is. Now I see all the backgrounds that came with Linux Mint that I can choose from. To change it, I just need to click on a picture. And I'll choose another one. How about this one here? And it updates right away. Let's go back to the default. Down at the bottom, we see Get More Backgrounds Online. I'm going to skip that because most of the people I know either put their own picture or make it a solid color. Let's look at how to make it a solid color. Down under these pictures, we have something called Colors, and then a drop down that says Solid Color. Next to that, we've got a box with a black rectangle in it. When I click that, it brings up the Pick a Color dialog box. We'll notice that everything is set to zero and the color is set to black. If I click on this up arrow on the hue, we notice that this triangle moves. It's got a little line on here. It's black. When the color gets darker, the line changes to white, and I can move it with my mouse by clicking and dragging on it. If I click the arrow up for red, we see this white circle going closer and closer to the red. And down at the bottom, we see the new color will be this dark red. The old color is black. To make this brighter, I can click and drag that circle to where I want it, or I can click anywhere in the triangle, and the circle goes right to where I clicked. And we see the new color is the color that's inside that circle. When I move the triangle, let's move it over here, maybe to the green, we see the corner with the line is updated to the color on this ring. The other two colors on the triangle are always white and black. We're on green. If I want to make this a lighter green, I move it to the white. If I wanted a darker green, I move it closer to the black. I can also type in the red, green, blue values if I know them, as well as the hue, saturation, and value. Or I can type in the HTML color value. We see the hex and then the hex numbers. But this also takes HTML color names. If I put in orange, we see it changes to orange. It even knows some of the more obscure HTML names like cornflower blue or papaya whip. When I click OK, we notice the background does not update to papaya whip. That's because we need to select the proper background. And that's this upper left-hand corner. It says no desktop background. When I click that, everything turns to black. Now when I click on the black rectangle, I can type in my cornflower blue. And when I click OK, the desktop becomes cornflower blue. I want to look at this eyedropper. If I click on this, any color I click on will become the new color. I'll click on a color inside one of these pictures, maybe blue. And it doesn't have to just be in the appearance preference window. I'll click on the eyedropper, and I'm going to come way down here to the menu. Maybe we want to make it, let's make it the red of this tie. There we go. And I'll click OK. And now the whole background is the same color as the red in that tie. I'm going to go back to the default picture. And I plugged in a flash drive. It has a few pictures on it. I want to add in some of my own background pictures. I'm going to select these three here, UW300, UW horizontal and vertical. It adds these in alphabetical order. So the last one is UWV after UWH, and the first one was UW300. I want to select that, and we see it's zoomed in. I'm going to change this to tile. So we see our picture is tiled from left to right and from top to bottom, the same picture over and over. The next style I want to choose is center. This shows us what the original size of the picture is. And I made this 300 pixels wide, so that's where the 300 comes from, and the UW is for underwater. Let's go back to style. And I'm going to now select stretch. What that does is stretches this corner of our picture and puts it into the corner of the desktop, and this other corner of the picture down to the lower right corner. And this one will probably distort your picture to make it fit the entire desktop. Now I'm going to change the style to scale. What that does is makes the picture fit the desktop as best it can, keeping the original scale. Next one we want to look at is zoom. This is why I added these other two pictures. I'm going to change our picture to UV horizontal with lines. We see with this zoomed in, the picture has got a little frame around it, these white lines going all around the picture. If I now change this to center, I'm going to minimize the appearance preferences window. We see white lines around the picture. So what happens with zoom is, zoom will zoom the entire picture to fit the desktop, meaning it will stop when the bottom of this picture hits the bottom of the desktop and the top of the picture hits the top of the desktop. These two parts on the sides will be out of view. So it zooms in as large as it can, keeping the scale, and then cutting off what we can't see. Let's try it with the UV vertical. It's zooming in. We see what looks like a frame around our picture. But when I change this to center, we see here that it zooms in the picture, keeping the scale until the left side hits the left part of the screen and the right side hits the right part of the screen. And we can only see what's inside this white box. The top and the bottom are outside of the desktop, so we don't see that. Let's go back into Appearance Preferences. We looked at Tile, that put them right next to each other. Zoom, that's the one we just saw, which zooms in but keeps things to scale. Center, that's what we have right now, where it centers the picture at its original size. Scale, scale the picture to the desktop, fitting the entire picture in. Stretch will stretch out the picture to fit the background. And we see this one is distorted a lot. And going back into center, we notice that we've got this background here. And this looks like it's that papaya whip. If I click on our window here, we can change the color. Maybe we'll make it this blue here. And we didn't look at the drop down for colors yet. We can add in a horizontal gradient. It gives us another color. The default is black. Maybe we want to make this one a dark purple. We can also make this a vertical gradient. So we can change the background color behind our centered picture. And we have one more here called span. What span does is it will stretch this across two monitors. If you have two monitors, Let me add in this last picture called Spanned. And we see it centers our picture between the two monitors. So you want to make sure that your picture is big enough to fill both monitors. This picture looks a little odd because it's centered the picture. It's really meant for a single monitor. We should probably put two pictures next to each other so the center part looks a little nicer. And we've got all this dark on the left and dark on the right. So we would probably want to go into GIMP or Pinta and put two pictures next to each other and use that as our desktop background. In the next video, we're going to continue looking at our Appearance Preferences dialog box.